higher, which came from the payroll on July 1st.
I think that's just was after the budget was adopted.
Yes. Okay. So, and we had a pretty spirited debate here about this issue. And Councilor Zdenski and I, who have about 36 years between us experience and police work, indicated that we thought that that position was, quite frankly, a waste of time. And I'm not going to go into the convoluted process that was used to hire the person. But now you want the $90,000 that the council cut because the mayor decided to go ahead and hire him anyway, while knowing the vote of this council. And I'm going to tell you, and I'm going to tell everyone else here, I have followed mayors and city councils since 1975, 41 years. And I have never run into an administration that basically says, in your face, city council, I really don't care what you think. I really don't care what you vote. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do what I want. Let me tell all of you how slick this move was. Instead of asking for money from mayor staff and coming to us and saying, you know, I'd like to have someone in the mayor's office to oversee police community relations and public relations, he went to the union, he negotiated with the union to have them accept that position at that salary, and now every chief and every mayor that comes after this year is going to be stuck with that position. Because I'm quite sure the union has tenure rights, and I'm quite sure if you went to eliminate someone, particularly someone with tenure rights, you went into a lengthy collective bargaining squabble litigation. And I gotta tell you, it's one of the slickest moves I've ever seen. At $90,000, we pay department heads here only about $1,400 more per year, and some of them have been here 38 years. Now, if we want to put our imprimatur on this and say, no problem, let the mayor do whatever he wants, and then when he spends the money, we'll be told him not to spend it, and he comes back to us looking for more money, then you know what, we don't really have to be here. But let him do whatever he wants, let him hire whoever he wants, let him set the salary, because clearly we're not going to be the guy against the taxpayer interest. And I think it's deplorable. There are very few issues that get me upset. But when somebody really insults your intelligence and basically says, again, in your face, I'm going to do what I want, that's unacceptable. And I am not going to vote for this. And I have questions to the chief as to how we arrived at the language for the future people who are going to be hired as dispatchers. My understanding is that they're in the union, and I think union members have a right to cross-bid into jobs. So you may not get anyone who is bilingual. You may get someone who wants to move from an SEIU position here over to dispatch. There's no guarantee. And we have many different languages in the city. We have a large Lithuanian population. We have a large Greek population, Hispanic. So I'm not quite sure, unless we have statistics that bear out, that we're getting call after call after call from Cape Verdean people who can't communicate, then I'm going to be a little suspect that we've got the data to back up what we want to do. The other thing I will tell you is the fire department, they handle 24,000 calls a year. We don't have anyone over there that speaks Cape Verdean as far as I know. And I would think that that department, above anyone else, would want to have someone who is bilingual. So if someone's having a heart attack, you could speak to them in their native language and tell someone how to perform CPR.